Netcasts you love.
From people you trust.
This is Twit.
Bandwidth for the Giz Wiz is brought to you by Cashfly at CACHEFLY.com.
It's time for the Giz Wiz with Mad's maddest writer, Dick DeBartolo. This is episode 1481, recorded Thursday, August 14th, 2014. A glowing review. This episode of the Giz Wiz is brought to you by NatureBox. Order great-tasting, healthy snacks delivered right to your door. Forget the vending machine and get in shape with healthy, delicious treats like coconut cashews. To get 50% off your first box, go to naturebox.com/twit. That's naturebox.com/twit.
And now, get ready for Dick.
On this episode of the Giz Wiz, we got gadgets for your phones, gadgets for your eyes, and gadgets for your house. All next.
It's the same dumb show with Dickie D.
And OMG Chad.
TV. It's time for the Giz Wiz because gadgets are his business. They've got a gizmo sickness, geek disease.
A nerd pathology.
Rows and rows of USBs. Growing glowing LEDs. Get ready for the Giz Wiz now.
Now! Hello, and I hope that you are ready for the Giz Wiz. And here he is, Mad's maddest writer, Dick DeBartolo. How are you doing, Dickie D?
I'm doing fine, sir. And you?
Doing very well. Doing really, really good. It's been a fun week. I don't know why this popped to mind, but last night I got like the best sleep that I've ever gotten in like 3 months.
Really?
Yeah.
Did you have trouble sleeping? Because I have terrible trouble sleeping.
Every once in a while, I'll get really bad. I'll have a lot of trouble sleeping. I'll toss and turn throughout the whole night. I'll just like wake up and just kind of have to sit up and drink water or something. It's just like I'm just awake and I can't do anything about it. But last night, for some reason, I was like, I'm going to get a good night's sleep. And I put in headphones, and I like shoot all the cats out of the room and close the door. And the only time that I woke up was because like I was drooling everywhere because I was just like completely asleep. It was absurd. It's like that's never happened to me. At least it hasn't happened in like months and months and months.
Oh my gosh!
Isn't that weird? And I don't know why, when you said, how are you doing? That was the image that popped to mind was, I had a really good sleep last night. That's what I thought.
Now, I have terrible sleep. I spend like an hour in my bed. Then I have a big black reclining chair. I get up and I sleep an hour there. And then I go back and I sleep in bed. But also what's kind of interesting is how your brain works is I get the Times delivered every day. And about once a week, it's just not there. And I think, does someone on their way to work take it? So if I wake up and it's like 5 or 6 o'clock when I think they're going to deliver the Times, I look out, put on a bathrobe and run out. They hang it on the front door of the building. I'm on the first floor. And so one morning I got up at 5 after 6 and a young man with 2 shopping bags is coming down the steps. And I think he's going to give me my Times. And I realize my Times is already on the door, and he takes my Times and puts it in the shopping bag and leaves.
What?
I know. So I was so PO'd, I ran out in the street in my bathrobe, and I said, I need my Times. So he threw it back to me.
So this guy probably picks up all the Times and then goes somewhere and sells them?
I think he might sell them to newsstands. Because one day I did buy a New York Times that was a little faded near the masthead, and I think it was where they had peeled off a label.
Oh, my gosh. Yeah.
So if anybody from the New York Times is watching, you should print subscription copies.
Right.
On
that
the
says
front
not
page.
For individual resale or something.
Yes.
Yeah.
Not for individual theft.
Yeah, right. Please, yeah. Maybe you could, under the no soliciting sign, put a no stealing my times, please.
No stealing my times.
Exactly. Sign. Yeah.
Exactly.
Yeah. It's funny. One more thing to talk about. Sleep. I've actually been tracking my sleep. There's an app. There's a few apps. One of them is called Sleep Cycle. The other one is called Sleep for Android, or sleep as Android. And so I've been...
Well, I don't want to sleep as Android. I want to sleep as the Prince of
Isn't
Wales.
Isn't that kind of a really weird sleep as Android?
Yeah, sleep for Android. Okay.
And so what you do is you can either set your phone next to your bed, and it will. You can see that I move around quite a lot.
How does it see what you're doing?
So there's the accelerometer in the phone will detect movement. So here, actually, I can tell it to start listening, like start tracking my sleep right now. Oh, sorry, there's a.
Okay.
And so what'll happen is if the phone doesn't move, it's not gonna really see anything. But if it starts to feel vibration, and obviously this is gonna be like way more than normal, you'll see the graph on this side. And it also dims. No, don't dim it. This graph should peak up. Oh, you know what? It's actually checking my wrist because I have this up with my Pebble, and so the Pebble will send the data, and so you can see that I'm moving an awful lot. And it does this every once in a while. This isn't
okay. So you need to have the watch, right?
You don't have to. So the main function of it is you'll just set the phone on the side of your bed. This probably wouldn't work if you sleep with someone else in the same bed, because it's going to detect the bed moving, which is you tossing and turning or waking up or whatever.
So if it's on the nightstand and the nightstand is not connected to the bed, it can still detect
It has to be on your bed. It has to be sitting on your mattress.
On your bed.
Right.
That makes sense.
Right.
Okay.
So it'll be on your mattress. And I had one from a different device from Gear 4 that it was an iPad stand, and it had a mini Doppler radar that was so powerful.
Pull over to the side of the road. You're dreaming too fast.
Exactly. It was so sensitive that it would detect the rising and falling of your breaths and of your chest. And based off of where you were in your sleep cycle, you breathe faster or slower and that sort of thing. So it would determine where you were in your sleep cycle or if you tossed and turned. And that was a really, really cool thing as well. But unfortunately, mine broke. And then also, they only sell them with a 30-pin connector, and lightning connector is what most iPads have now. And I found other options when mine broke. But yeah, so I've been trying to for the past little while to track my sleep, and it's been kind of interesting. Right here,
wow, you earned 5 stars last night.
So this is how I get to rate it. So this is
you get to rate it.
Yeah, I get to rate it. I haven't rated this one. Right here, the phone fell off the bed onto the floor.
I see, okay.
So you can see that there's no information there, but. Yeah, and this is I'm not sure. Now, last night was the first night that I've ever used the watch to track, and you can kind of see. I think this was when I originally went to bed right here, and then I didn't wake up until I realized that I was drooling everywhere. It was kind of disgusting, but yeah. So I've been tracking my sleep with Sleep as Android.
Yeah, you must have been, because I see the little ads that are showing up from Google off of waterproof sheets.
Right. So
must have detected the drooling. Wow.
Yeah. Yes. Yeah.
Nothing we do goes unnoticed in this digital age.
Absolutely. I'll get a Google Now notification. So it looks like you didn't sleep that well. There's coffee on the way to work if you would like to pick some up. Yeah.
And all your emails now are going to say, "Hey, drooling Chad."
So let's get into our first gadget.
Our first gadget. I like this a lot. We did a UNU device a couple of weeks ago. It was a secondary battery for the Galaxy 5. It's a case that has a second battery, and it doubles the battery life of the battery that's in there already. It's quite unique. So evidently they saw the review and they sent me an email saying, "We have another product. Can we send you one?" And this is really unique. It's called the UNU Ultrapack. So this is what it looks like. And what's fascinating about this is it's an external battery charger. What's unique about this is it charges itself really fast.
Wow.
What I did was I drained it down to zero, And just as we, just when Josh called me, I plugged it in from zero.
Oh, wow.
And in 15 minutes.
Whoa.
It is actually, we saw it a little bit later. It's probably 25 minutes. It's 95% capacity. So what it does is it charges itself at an astounding 31.25 watts. You know, like charges are like 2 watts.
31? Whoa.
30. When this is at zero and you plug it in, you can stand there and you see it go 1%, 2%, 3%. So the object here is, this is kind of interesting. I'm just going to look at their stats here, is if you plug an iPhone 5 in for 15 minutes, an iPhone 5 will have 9% power. If you plug it into an AC, if you have an AC charger charging a regular external device, in 15 minutes, you'll have about 11% power. The Ultrapack in 15 minutes has 75% power. So I drained it down to zero and started a stopwatch. And at 15 minutes, by a stopwatch, it had 76% power. So the object here is this is 3,000 milliamps. So in 15 minutes, you could plug this into your phone and go the entire day with this charging your phone or running your phone if your phone battery is down. They make two versions, the 3,000 milliamp version, which is this guy, which, by the way, is pretty compact.
Yeah.
Now, the thing is, you really will be charging this at home or in the office because this is not one of those devices that the plug is inside. So it has a formidable plug for it.
Right. And it doesn't look like it can deal with like a micro USB, which makes sense because I don't think you can fit 31 watts.
Yeah, 31.25 watts.
Yeah.
But I was just amazed at how fast this thing can charge. They make this one. And they make another one, which is 10,000 milliamps. This guy is $59.99. And the 10,000 milliamp version, which has two charging ports, is $100, $99.99. They're not quite out yet. I see you. Does it say available now, or does it say next week or something?
Let me look. Due to the extreme demand, the Ultrapack will be shipped August 25th.
Okay, and if you go on Amazon, I believe it the date's a little later. I think on Amazon it says August 31st. We can just show this a little company video. It's only 1 minute. So let's see that. It might give you some things I forgot.
Right.
Ultra.
Introducing the Ultrapack Fast Charging Battery Pack Series from UNU. The Ultrapack has the unique ability to collect all-day lasting power in just 15 minutes. Featuring Ultra-X charging technology, the Ultrapack can recharge itself up to 8 times faster when compared to conventional batteries. The Ultrapack is available in 2 convenient sizes, the Tour and Go. Allowing you to charge on the go, the Ultrapack is a powerful yet stylish travel companion. With the ability to charge smartphones and tablets, the Ultrapack is the perfect charging alternative. Additional features of the Ultrapack include an intelligent LED screen, integrated flashlight, universal USB charging ports, a long-lasting internal battery, and durable framing. The Ultrapack series. Experience the revolution in charging, where 15 minutes of charge gives you all-day lasting power.
Oh, I guess I pretty much got it. I forgot the flashlight.
The flashlight. It has a flashlight. I'm pulling
the most
out.
Important thing in the world, the flashlight.
So this Samsung Galaxy S5 Sport has a 2,800 milliamp hour battery.
Right. So you would get one full charge out of this.
Yeah, a full charge.
Yeah, what I did is the only phone I had laying around that was totally dead was the Galaxy 2. Which I think was 2,300 milliamps, and this charged it and had about 20% power left, so it's about right.
Right.
But it's a great thing for travel or any day where you know you're going to be busy and you want to have a device to charge other devices.
Right. Now that it takes 15 minutes to charge the battery, but when the battery's charging a phone, it's normal speed?
Exactly. Right. Yes, they can't change the circuitry, but that's a very good point.
Right.
So the little guy is Ultrapack Go, that's this guy, and the big one is called the Ultrapack Tour. And as we mentioned, probably a week or two away if you're watching this about when we tape it on August 14th.
Perfect. And for those who are wondering, an iPhone has about 1,500 milliamp hours. The iPhone 5, I think, is like 14-something, and then the iPhone 5S is 15. So it'll charge that phone twice.
Twice.
Close to twice.
Close to twice.
Close to twice. Very, very cool. I think that's really neat because there's a lot of times when I'm getting ready to go to the airport, I forget that I haven't charged my external battery. And the one that I carry takes a while to charge, but it's...
Yes, and you sit there and it goes, eh. And you go to the bathroom, wash your hands, you come back. It's up 1%.
That's cool. That's really cool.
Yeah, this thing you will really like. Yeah. It just go, wah.
Yep. Cool. Second gadget.
I'm turning around to get my second device. And this is I love my gadgets today. So instead of showing you what it is, I'm going to let the video explain it. So take it away, video man.
You know, it's fun recording videos for the Giz Wiz show on Twit. The problem is lugging stuff around. You know, like right here, we're using a camera that Dennis has. I'm wearing my mic. But out in the field, we have to carry a lot more stuff. Something happens to that camera, we need to have another camera that we have to drag along. And then if we're planning on having a guest, we have to drag along another microphone. And then we decided that sometimes when we're out on a shoot, there's not enough lighting. So we decided let's add a lighting kit and a lighting stand and a charging cable and a diffuser to our bag of tricks. So now we have another bag to carry with us. I know, it's a lot of stuff. So everything I talked about is in this little bag, okay? The gadget is called iBlazr, okay? It's iBlazr, Z-R, they left the E out, and it came from bitemyapple.co, okay? .co, not .com. All right, so let's look at the iBlazr kit. This is really quite nifty. So here we have the charging cable. Here we have the light stand. Here we have the diffuser. And here we have the iBlazr. Okay, so this is pretty nifty. So what you do, you want to first check the battery level. This has its own battery in it, by the way. It doesn't depend on your phone or iPad. So you push the button once, and all four lights lit. That meant it's 100% charge. If one light lights, it's 25% charge. So now it is on. You download the iBlazr app, and this is for smartphones. Like, this is great for the iPad that I believe has no flash. I don't have an iPad, but I believe
there's no flash in an iPad.
So
you plug it into the headphone jack. Okay, I'm going to turn my phone on, and I'm going to go to the iBlazr. Okay, it says insert, and then we're looking through the camera now. We go to settings, and it's on, and oh, there it is. Okay, so now, look at this. You have complete control over the intensity of the iBlazr. And you can use it as a video light. Right now we're using it as a video light. I'm gonna just turn it off here for a second. Oh, I just turned it on to turn the camera around. So what's neat about this is it has its own battery built in. So you can actually, if you want to, you're lighting up something at a shoot and it's very dark. Push it once.
Oh, wow.
That's low. Push it twice, medium. push it three times, and it's high. So when it's on
also,
its little stand, it has
someone who watched the video said that little stand is also a cold shoe.
When it's
oh,
in
it
your
is.
Own, you
yes.
can dial
You're
the intensity
right.
any way
you
want.
You can slap that onto
and
a little.
You can take it out, yeah, and you can use it as a little flashlight if you like. In video mode, it just stays lit.
That seems really bright.
And I'm
going to
look over here because it tells you let's see, power mode. So on low, 3 hours of light. Second power mode, 50 minutes of light. And then when you have all four LEDs full up, 25 minutes of light. But that's a lot of light if you're doing a quickie video. You know, our videos are usually 3 to 5 minutes. So this would be plenty of light for that. It's also synced to your camera. And I can tell you one thing about it. It says it's for the Galaxies. I do have some trouble using it on the Galaxy S5. Nothing to do with the Galaxy S5 or the device. It's that the Galaxy S5 is waterproof. And there's a little ring around the headphone jack. And you have to push that in hard, and it doesn't make contact each and every time. Under $50, I think, $49.99. And this was a Kickstarter project. They wanted, I'm going to look at my notes. They wanted $58,000 to get going. And they raised almost $100,000 more than that. They raised over $156,000. So it's iOS 7 and up. I'm looking at the notes again. It's Android 4 and higher. So that is pretty neat. The iBlazr. And I think Dennis showed you a picture of on their website. Or the iBlazr website.
You know, it's funny. Look at it. It says smartphone flash.
Smartphone flash.
Ah, there we are. Thank you, iBlazr. Dick DeBartolo, Mads Medis Writer, and the Giz Wiz, One Take Theater. I think you see why. Here on Twit. Bye.
That's really, really cool.
Isn't that neat? So I got some specs from the tech people. At the lowest thing, it's 16 lux. In the second power mode, it's 60 lux. In the third power mode, it's 120 lux at 3 feet. Flash mode is 270 lux. Dimmable from 0 to 100 through the app. Or you can use one of the three levels when it's a standalone. And this is pretty neat. It'll work with an audio extension cable. So if you want to use it as an off-camera flash, plug the audio extension cable into your phone, plug this into the extension, and then you can use it as an external flash.
That's really neat. And it's because it's using the battery inside the iBlazr. It's now, and there's no way to charge it from your phone. You have to plug it into the charger.
Yes, you have to. You plug it into. You can plug it into your Unu and have it run forever.
Right. Exactly. Exactly. So, and the charger it comes with it is like a little USB.
Yes. Exactly. Okay. I've already misplaced it. But yeah, it was a little piece of cable.
Yeah.
About that. And it comes with that little mini bag. And here. I'm not totally lost. Here we go. This is the kit. So you get the little cable, the thing, and the iBlazr, and you get the little
diffuser work? Did you like that?
You know, the diffuser is interesting because you don't see the four dots of light. Something like that. Yeah. It's very clever. Very clever.
Yeah, that looks really neat. I've been looking for a lighting solution for just like a little webcam. And
this is, yes, us too. You know, sometimes we go to shoot something at like a CES booth where it's very dark in that corner. And this is an ideal mini, mini solution.
Yeah.
And the fact that you have three levels to go to is will give you enough variety to just light a small device. It's great.
Yeah. Oh, my God. Yeah. I want to buy some for Twit or just myself. These seem really
there's,
cool.
There's, for some reason, I don't know, I could find nothing different about it. There is a deluxe aluminum model. This is plastic.
Mm.
And that's $49.99. There is an aluminum model, and it just says Pro. but it doesn't say anything different that the Pro does.
God, they look like they have a few really cool lighting things. This is little, I'm just looking at this little Nova thing.
You're at the Bite My Apple.
Yeah, I'm looking at their website. They just have some really neat looking.
And you spell out Apple. You don't have to actually draw the Apple. And it's .co, not .com.
Wow.
Yeah, I didn't go past the iBlazr website. That is a nice website.
Yeah. And I'm just looking at. They have all sorts of stuff. If you if you click in, they have. They have lots and lots of little products, here on their site.
Great.
Oh, did they the glyph? Oh, yeah. I've seen a few products from this company. They like to start stuff on Kickstarter. Oh, and they did the Luxie, which is another Kickstarter. They like to start stuff on. Wait, do they?
No, they don't make this.
Oh, they don't make this. This is just them selling, this.
Oh, okay.
So the Olo clip. I was like, wait, what?
wait, I invented that.
Exactly. I was like, wow. Where have these people been? Okay. Yes. They're also a store, and then I think that they also do maybe some of their own products as well. Very neat. Very, very neat.
Very neat.
Cool. The iBlazr. I want to buy one.
That's clever. I'm going to have it when I go to a trade show too to shoot video. It's going to be very helpful.
Yeah, really neat. And the cost is, well, I think you said $49.99.
$49.99.
Perfect. Yeah, perfect.
For the little kit.
Yeah. Great.
All right, Chad, for the next gadget, do we have a person in the studio who has not seen the rundown?
Padre? Could we borrow you for half a second?
I don't ever look at the rundown, so
we just need a person.
Josh doesn't look at Josh.
I'm not prepared at all. I don't know what's happening on this show.
We need someone who hasn't looked at our rundown to be surprised. So we just need.
Oh, we can ask the chat room if no one shows up.
He's here. He's right here. He's walking in.
Okay. Okay.
Okay. This is Padre SJ, our resident hacker, and also a priest.
Okay. So, Padre, I'm sure you can tell by looking at this what this is, right?
Night vision goggles?
Close.
It's a sleep mask.
A sleep mask. Okay, but the question is, Padre, why is the front a hard surface?
So that it doesn't let in the light?
No.
So that you don't accidentally eat it?
No.
So that it's bulletproof? Because people shoot at you in your sleep?
No, that's a good idea, though. I think we should patent that one. Well, you know what? I'll tell you. It's very bizarre, but it's very useful. It comes with its own writing utensil, and this is a whiteboard.
So I imagine if you're asleep, someone can give you a note while you're...
No. You know, Chad, I wish I had this once when I was so tired and so hungry on a flight, and I wanted to hang a note on my button saying, please wake me for the meal.
That's not what it's going to be used for.
That is funny.
Your roommates are going to come into your room and draw things on your face. But now.
Oh, that's okay.
Yeah.
That's okay. Or you can say... Honey, I didn't get much sleep. Don't wake me up. Thank you, Padre, for your participation.
Padre. I didn't mean
you'll get turtle wax in the mail.
That is
new
really
turtle
fun.
Wax confessional for making the confessional shiny and bright.
That is really funny. So
is that fun?
Is that what they total? So they suggest is like on a plane you can write a message or
yes, it's called total eclipse. So they say that you can sleep in total darkness, but the white erasable surface lets you put messages. I guess if you're a chicken, you could write, honey, I want a divorce. So when the person comes home.
Oh, yeah. Honey, taking a nap.
There you go.
Dinner is in the oven.
there you go. Another one they suggested was, will someone please wake me when we get to the Main Street station?
Okay. Yeah, please wake me for beverage service. Thanks. Wow. Or you could just draw a whole bunch of eyeballs so it looks like you're awake in class.
That's what Dennis thought would be funny, is to make it look like you're wide awake. You know what? If you can go back to their website, Josh, I forgot. I think they also sell a mask where it looks like your eyes are open on it. There you go.
They do. They do. Yeah. Wow. That is very funny. And it's funny, I was wondering what these little things on the side are. They're holders for your earplugs.
Which is a great idea because they send you earplugs with the mask. And I always have earplugs, but I can never find them because they fall to the bottom of your bag.
I have. Yes, I decided to fight the problem.
Is there nothing? I don't think we've ever done a spot where you didn't have part of it in that bag.
Probably not. I constantly run out of earplugs. So my solution was to carry so many of them that I would never, ever, ever run out of earplugs. Wow. And then also,
now, you don't use all those at one time and just keep plugging them in.
But also, these are all the fresh ones. These have never been in any human's ears. And then I try to put my used ones over on a side pouch. And that way, not only are you the guy who has earplugs, but you also are the guy who has earplugs for your whole row. Of all the people sleeping on the plane, so you can easily make friends like immediately by being like, anybody wants some fresh earplugs?
Oh my word!
And you just buy them because you always forget to bring your earplugs with you on the plane, and if you buy them in the airport, they're like $5 for a pair.
Yeah. Yes.
And so I keep tons of earplugs on me. In my travel bag.
That's very funny.
Yeah.
And Josh, I know you ran it for just run. It's just 59 seconds. Just run that thing in case I forgot anything about.
Perfect. The total eclipse.
Total eclipse.
Perfect. And it looks like that's great.
Oh, they make it in black. Okay.
Yeah.
Oh, they make the total eclipse blackboard.
I originally thought that the headphone thing on the side was for a tiny little pin, but
that would have been a good idea. Oh, actually, the pen has an eraser head on the back of it.
Oh, perfect. Right there. That is so funny.
Here are some examples.
Please wake me up for food service. Great.
Food service. That's what I would use.
I hope that they can see it. Do not disturb. Right.
No.
I'm in a meeting.
Oh, that's good. Right. Wake me up at 7 a.m. This is assuming your seatmate is. You could put an ad on it.
Yeah, exactly.
You can watch twit.tv.
right. Some people call me OMG.
Yeah, there you go.
That's really funny.
$25. Yeah, $24.95 on Amazon, and it's Amazon Prime.
That's great.
So, something different. Total eclipse sleep mask. And white or blackboard.
Great. Well, we have coming up next my crappy corner. We still have the warehouse and a letter. But first, we have to thank one of my favorite sponsors to thank on the show, NatureBox. NatureBox is the way for you to get great tasting snacks delivered to your door, hand delivered by humans, not by robots yet. But I absolutely adore NatureBox. I've been a subscriber for a while now. And the idea is that you sign up on their website, naturebox.com/twit, if you want a special deal. I'll mention that again later. And you choose the snacks that you want delivered to you. And then snacks arrive at your door. And each box has 5 snacks that you can choose from. And the cool thing is that these snacks are great. They're all of them, 0 trans fats, 0 high fructose corn syrup, and nothing artificial. On top of that, if you have dietary restrictions, as many of us do, there's great search tools on the website to make sure that you can drill down by vegan, soy-free, gluten-conscious, lactose-free, nut-free, or non-GMO. And on top of that, you can even drill down by taste, sweet, savory, or spicy. Ah, man, just head out on over to naturebox.com. They have a great place for you to check out all the snacks that they have. Just start looking around. You'll see something that you want, and I know that it's going to be delicious when it gets delivered. Here in front of me, I have a few. We have whole wheat, blueberry figgy bars.
Ooh,
I've had a
few
of their figgy bars, and they're really nice. And they're also individually packaged, so if you want to throw them into a child's lunch box, this would be a great option. Baked cheddar potato
fries. I just finished
fries.
My bag of those. They are great.
Oh, so very good. Sweet salt sun crunch. Sweet. I haven't actually tried this one. Oh, wow. It looks like they're little medallions. Oh, man. Mm. Oh, gosh. I'm going to keep this one over here. Lone Star snack mix, which I've had, and baked potatoes, sweet baked potato fries. And on top of that, we just got one that I had never had before, which was coconut cashews. It's cashews, and they've somehow been coated in coconut. So good. It's not like coconut. I don't know how to describe it. It is just so tasty. I have been nomming on those for the last week. It's like they somehow figured out how to jellify coconut. And then put it around a cashew.
And then put it in a bag and
then I eat them all. I just eat all of them. Oh, so tasty. So if you want to test out NatureBox, I have a deal for you. Twit has pulled off the best deal in the world. 50% off your first box by heading over to naturebox.com/twit. You can get a whole box for half price. So please head on over to naturebox.com/twit, and I know that you will enjoy snacking happy with NatureBox. Stay fit, stay full, stay strong with NatureBox. And these sea salt sun clusters are going right next to my computer, and I'm going to eat them later. Thanks, NatureBox, for your support of the Giz Wiz.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, you voted for home improvement gadgets, so now it's time for that amazing theme.
But you might want it at Chad's Crappy Corner.
Okay, I have a lot.
All right,
I have a lot to pull out in my Crappy Corner. So we're going to start one at a time. First, let me just go ahead and reveal to you what my gadget is. We wanted to cover something that was kind of something original that you would add to your house. And we were looking for something that you might be able to paint because people need to paint their homes all the time.
Yeah, okay.
We ran across this, which is glow-in-the-dark paint. This is blue, but we bought the green glow-in-the-dark paint. And so we went ahead and ordered it. It's $10 for the amount that you see there. So what we imagined when it arrived was something about this sized, right?
Yeah, that's right.
You looked at we don't have to show the Amazon ad again, but you'd imagine that it'd be about this,
like that.
That's what it kind of looked like in the image. Little did we know, one second here, have to put on some protective gloves because this is pretty
man's work.
Well, it's man's work. It's radioactive man's work, let me tell you.
Wow.
Okay. Here we go.
Whoa.
Some more precautions. Radioactive material here, guys.
Can I write on those glasses?
Hope you're ready. if you really need to, I think we can. Okay. And here it is. No, I'm kidding. This is not the size. It actually came. This is the size of paint that we got. You didn't notice on the article?
You know what? I was talking about anti-fouling paint is $330 a gallon.
Yeah.
So I noticed that it said half an ounce.
Half an ounce is what we
is
got.
$10.
If half you expected to get even a shot glass's worth of paint, you were wrong. We got half an ounce of paint. Me and Jeff actually did not realize you saw half an ounce. We didn't. We expected truly to get some sort of paint that was this size.
Yeah,
this
is an impulse buy. I saw the half an ounce, but it looks like a big half ounce, you know?
So, buyer beware, this was $10 if you wanted this. I cannot see a thing. Woo, with these red glasses on.
So
this
basically, if you wanted to paint the room, you're in for about $1,000.
Oh, yeah. So on top of that, on the instructions for this, it mentions that you should paint, was it a sixth or a sixteenth? A sixth of an inch thick. So 2 ounces, a sixteenth of an inch, 2 ounces will cover a square foot. We have a half an ounce, so it'll do a fourth of that. So around like 5.5 square inches is what this will paint. So oh, and the other funny thing is that
they sell it
in the gallon.
There you go, Chad. There's your bargain. $500.
$100 for a gallon, and then $1,500 for the 4 gallons. So yeah.
Check the shipping on that. Chad,
I believe it's Amazon.
Right? No, it's not. It's an additional.
Oh, it's an additional $159.98. Jeez! Oh my gosh. Okay, so we brought out an old friend. If you didn't know, we've always had an emergency Giz Wiz gadget, the 2x4, in case I don't have a gadget. So we're actually going to take our friend the 2x4 and use him to kind of show off.
Wow.
Show off the glow.
That is one lucky 2x4, I'll tell you.
So, just show
off. Is there no priming or anything?
Maybe. I don't know. This is the Giz Wiz. We don't have a paintbrush. We just have Q-tips.
Oh, my God. This show, really.
So, yeah. We've actually already used this, and I'll show you that footage later. But the consistency of this is kind of interesting. It's a lot less like paint and a lot more like a cream. It's really difficult to describe the consistency of this. I'd expect to paint it on sort of with a brush.
Could I wear it like sunscreen?
I'd expect to put that on a bagel.
It's just very, I actually do have a brush here.
Oh my gosh, brush. I love the fact that you have work gloves, you have safety goggles, and we have no paintbrush.
Yeah, we had no paintbrush. So painting it is really a difficult matter. And so it's more of a cream instead of a actual paint, which was a little bit distressing. And then you also have to get that sixteenth of an inch. So you have to kind of like make sure that you get it just right where, it's a little difficult. So I don't know what masterpiece I'm painting here, but I was actually planning on making a smiley face, but I just kind of went off the rails here. Here, we'll try to fix this up. He'll just be a little glowy there in the center. Anyway,
if that's a smiley face, you have a much bigger imagination than I do.
Listen, you got to learn how to create before you can deconstruct.
Oh, I see. And, it wasn't finished.
Yeah,
now it's just scream smiley face.
Oh my gosh. Okay. You doubted me. We went ahead and painted some of the studio, so we have some footage of that while I'm finishing up my masterpiece over here.
Wow.
This is the technical director's desk that we're painting. We use Q-tips for this.
Oh, what a great idea.
So the idea was that, the studio lights would be shut off, and you'd want to see the side of the technical director's desk. And so that we use Q-tips for that one. We didn't quite have paintbrush technology discovered. We hadn't quite spent the sim points yet.
Who did the masking job? That's great.
That's me. That was me.
Wow, that is.
So here's our smiley face board, which you can finish him up. Looking good. So let's go check out. This is, of course, not dried. So we have some areas of the studio that we have painted and is dried. Whoa, I'm stepping over my... and we have a flashlight. So we have a handheld camera. We're shutting off the lights. Let me go ahead and close this as well. And let's check out some of the areas that we've painted. First is right here on this camera cage. We wrote down high. So okay. Here's it. This is, I think, it passively done from the studio lights, or did you just hit this? Oh, and then Jeff energized it a bit. So if I take this LED stick, which we've had, we can hit it for just a little while with this light, and then take it
so
away.
So it's getting energy from any kind of light?
Yes, any kind of light. And we were pretty impressed.
That's pretty nice.
We had hit this before, and it does stay energized for quite a while. I'm going to go ahead and hit it with some light so you can see how thick this is. This is about what they recommend in spots here.
Oh, boy, that is thick.
So it's fairly thick there. This was two coats. This one right here was two coats. You can kind of imagine. And if we hit it one last time, I'm going to hit this, just this one portion of the H here to see just how energized we can get it. And there you go.
Oh, you can see the difference.
Right. Right. So that's a little bit of it. And then also over here, we have Jeff energizing right now the bottom of the technical director's desk.
Okay.
So if we turn that off.
Someone in the chat room asking if it has a smell to it.
It does not. You know, it's funny. Apparently, there's a few people who really care about if it smells, because Alex went up and sniffed the high. And I kind of thought that was a little weird, but apparently...
No, because a lot of people don't like the smell of paint, so...
Yeah, it doesn't smell anything. We have Patrick Norton here who's saying it doesn't smell like a thing. So the TD desk didn't... This was a lot thinner of a paint job here on the bottom of the TD desk. And so it doesn't stay energized quite as well. Can kind of see them there. Now this corner of the desk a lot more than the rest. We gave it a lot more layers.
Okay.
So the thickness of the paint is definitely.
Wow. That and that end thing is really bright. That's
right.
Yeah.
Right. So all in all, this amount of paint that we did with kind of the not so good stuff, one corner that was really good, and then the high, that was about a fourth of an ounce of paint. So you can, and there's Josh.
Hi.
Hey.
Hey, Josh. Do Josh's teeth.
Oh,
what?
Yeah.
Do his teeth.
Who has a toothbrush?
Let's
do this.
Sure, we got one. Somewhere.
That's the only way we can get them to brighten.
And then Jeff and Alex are over here, and they're, oh my God. Cut to the product shot pretty quickly, if you would. He's making a sandwich with it. It's a little hard to tell, but
wow,
that is.
Wow, glow-in-the-dark peanut butter and jelly.
Here, if you cut to the product, or to the handheld, I think he has a little bit better. It's actually glowing.
Oh, wow.
On the, Oh, God.
And now,
you know, it definitely does not say non-toxic.
Blair Witch Margarine. Blair Witch Margarine presents the Giz Wiz.
Wow. So that is one thing, is that it does use I forget how to say this. Highest grade strontium. Strontium. Strontium is the thing it uses to energize. It is toxic, so do not eat any of it, children. So that is our half an ounce of ultra glow glow-in-the-dark paint.
So you would say it's good for like safety things, but you'd never do a room with it, right?
I don't think so. And we're energizing it right before you see it on a camera, which we're making sure to rake up so you can see part of it.
Okay.
We have pictures from this morning. It's okay. It's okay. It is a little bit impressive. This is his photos from this morning. It's a little bit impressive. There is another.
Okay.
The first
coat? The company
coat,
may want to use that in an ad. Is that okay?
That high.
OMGchad right says it's a little bit impressive.
It's a tiny bit impressive. Like, you might be able to show it off to your friends, and it'd be a tiny bit impressive. Look at that glow, folks. This is before we did the second coat on it. It's really hard to recommend. And the other reason it's really hard for me to recommend is because I've used glow tape before in theater situations where it's way easier to apply, way more consistent. Glow tape is extremely expensive as well. I think anything that glows is. But it's going to give you a much more consistent product if you're trying to do some sort of safety thing. So I would recommend glow tape over this. It was difficult to apply. It wasn't consistent. So keep that in mind. Jeff, do you back me up on this? Yeah, he says don't buy it, basically. $10 for half an ounce of glow.
Fortunately, in the studio, I have glow worms. And they, I say, guys, places, and they all get into the where they.
Is that your current lighting situation?
Yeah, exactly. Perfect. And they stay there just for an hour for the show. And then I go, okay, come back Saturday for Giz Fizz, and they're off. And, it's free.
So that is the Ultra Glow Glow in the Dark Paint, half a fluid ounce for $10.
$10.
This is the size of it. not an actual like 2 ounce thing. So keep that in mind. Now moving on to the Giz Wiz Gadget Warehouse. Now.
They're geeky and they're goofy. Together they are loopy. When gadgets pass away, he takes them out to play in Dick's Gadget Warehouse.
Woo! What do you got for us this week, Dickie D?
Okay, we got a mini letter that says, my gadget warehouse submission is from Daniel. Actually, that was his entire email. here is my gadget warehouse submission for your show from Daniel, and it's impressive. Okay, Daniel, take it away.
Hey, Dick and Chad, Daniel here. I want to show you guys a piece of my gadget warehouse. For those of you born after a certain age, a certain date, you probably don't recognize this. This is the original Atari 2600 game system. As a kid, this was for a lot of us. This was our very first game system that we ever owned. And I enjoyed many, many, many years growing up playing this thing. But that's not exactly what I want to show you. I also have, and this is where you spend the money, or your parents' money.
The game.
The cartridges.
The cartridges. I was right.
Now, in this drawer here, there's about 225 cartridges.
Wow.
All kinds of games, obviously multiples, some 10 of, 10 Pac-Mans, 20 Froggers.
Wow.
I don't
know. There's also this drawer that also has about 250 cartridges in it.
Wow.
All manufacturers. But wait, there's more. This drawer here is also full.
It's like the perfect
this drawer
cartridge
here is also full.
Cabinet.
Yeah, it's the Atari
but wait, there's
chest.
More.
Wait, there's more.
Good, there's more.
I've also got this storage container that's got about 70 boxes in it.
Wow.
Most of them have the games in them as well, instructions and things like that. I've even got the Star Raiders that came with the touchpad, and my favorite game of all time, Pitfall. I think I played this more than anything.
It's a good game.
All in all, there's a little over probably 650 games here, but I can't quite credit it to myself. My cousin Mike lives in Hawaii, and he and his fiance are getting married soon, and guess who's the one that has to downsize? So he shipped all these over to me from Hawaii in banker's boxes, also known as file folder boxes. And he sent me 9 of them that had all of this in it. And each box cost him about $40. So he spent about $350 to get it over here to me. So I want to give him the credit for this. As of right now, these will probably stay in my warehouse in perpetuity, because technically I don't quite own them. And that's my gadget warehouse. Love the show, guys. And Chad, I'm still voting for that red mustache. Come on, buddy. Show me the money. Bye, guys.
I'll need to work on that.
Wow. So as a gaming months. Person, why would you have like 10 copies of something?
Also if you're a collector, sometimes you'll buy batches and you'll just end up with extras.
Oh, I see. Okay.
Right. But also it could be limited edition copies versus non-limited edition copies, the Japanese copy versus the American copy. There could also be that as well. I wonder how many ETs he has, because...
It's fascinating. Somebody mailed me a box of books, and they said, do you happen to have a copy of Mad Murders, the Movies, the third printing in Sweden? So what? Didn't even know there's such a thing.
And that's like the only book he's missing.
Yes.
That's why he needs it.
He's collecting every book I wrote in every language, but... in every printing.
Yeah, wow.
I said, sir, I have like two copies on a shelf somewhere. I have no idea what printing they are. So it's kind of interesting that people zoom in on something and then make sure they get every one available.
Having the versionings is a big deal, because you can see what changed. It's a little piece of history that... the first edition had this in it, and the second edition had this in it.
Oh, that's interesting. That is interesting.
Yeah. I remember one of my favorite things was there's a bookstore in Austin, Texas called Half Price Books. And they'd always have a corner of the bookstore that was all the rare books. And it had first edition, so you'd see like a first edition of one of the Harry Potter books in there, and it'd be $300, you know.
Was that half price of 600, or was
basically,
it
basically? Yeah.
Oh my gosh.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. I mean, it was. Yeah. Really, really cool stuff. People. There's definitely a culture around making sure you have the all editions, and to me, I'll just read about it on Wikipedia. But
yeah, me too. Me too. Anyway, thank you, Daniel. And if you want to submit a video, we're looking for videos. I invented this. My favorite gadget of all time, I bought a piece of crap, or our all-time favorites, my gadget warehouse. And just like Daniel, 2 or 3 minutes showing what it is, and maybe a little history about how you got it. And just email our producer, Jeff Needles. I think there's a 30-page application that Jeff is coming up with, but it's not enforced yet.
Right.
So send us your videos really quickly, gizwiz@twit.tv. And we show it on the show, like we did Daniel's video, Daniel gets a piece of crap, gets an autographed copy of Mad Magazine and an Alfred E. Newman picture. So do it.
All sorts
Put it
of stuff.
On YouTube and send us the link.
That's a great litmus test if you should make a video on it or not, is if it's been sitting in your garage for a long time and you just can't get rid of it. Do you have a storage unit? Do you have a garage? And you just look through it and you go, there's that one thing that I just cannot get rid of. I just love it too much. Like a huge collection of Atari games and Atari.
Yeah.
It's good.
And amazingly, other people like hearing about that.
Oh, I love hearing about it.
Yeah,
and what else are you going to do with it? Like, show people that passion. That's, absolutely. Very, very cool. So let's move on to the letter.
New themes.
Here come the letters. Oh, yeah. Oh, here come the Giz Wiz letters now. Love it.
Woo.
Love it. Good theme.
And our letter is from Ken Berger. Hi, Dick and Chad. First, I have to apologize for having the nerve to take a vacation and fall behind on my Giz Wiz episodes. I'm watching episode 1475, not too far back. I just saw Chad struggle with the pronunciation of A, B, C, D, E, F. We were talking about keyboards. We were saying... QWERTY, it's easy to say QWERTY keyboard, but for the man who invented the ABCD. Right.
Yeah.
I immediately thought of an episode of Sesame Street that my kids watched in the early 80s. And here's just a little bit of this just might help you, Chad.
Oh.
It's quite a word. You ready to hear it?
Sure.
Okay, listen to this. Abkadepki Jekyllman Knockwurstuwixies.
I beg your pardon, did you?
That's the word. Abkadepki Jekyllman Knockwurstuwixies.
Abka, what? Where did you see that word?
Abkadepki.
Right over there in the yard.
Oh, in the yard.
Abkadepki.
Sure.
Yeah, so it's.
Oh, there?
Whoa. That
so it's.
Is some kind of word. Whoa. Abkadefki, Jekyllman, not course to Wixies. It's the most remarkable word I've ever seen.
So you got your, you got the pronunciation?
There we go.
Okay.
It's the Abkadefki Giz Wiz keyboard.
Yeah. Keyboard.
Yeah, that's a great gem. That's so funny.
And then Ken Berger says, thanks for the laughs. Keep up the good work. And Ken Berger from Philly, PA. So, Ken, thank you for your email and for enlightening us on the proper pronunciation.
Yeah. And Jeff Needles goes, hooray for what was it? Philadelphia, Pennsylvania.
So, oh, is that his hometown, right?
Apparently. He's, I didn't even know that. Maybe I did. He says I did. He's looking at me with daggers in his eyes.
Okay. As is his wont, by the way.
Yes, as is his style. Thanks for sending that in. That's really, really great. And also, don't forget, if you're watching, play the What the Heck Is It game. We're coming up. How much longer do we have until...
Until the end of August.
Ooh.
And they get the mad with...
This guy
us
and
in it, you
that
in
guy.
It,
and Leo and Lisa in it,
and Lisa, yeah, the whole Twitch family.
I've been trying to figure out a way to frame the magazine, and I guess I need to go to a custom frame shop to do it, because what I want is the one that you signed to me in one panel, and then the it opened to the page that I'm in it on the other. So I need to get like a really long frame. I don't know. I'm trying to figure it out still.
That would be good, the cover and we call that the splash, the two-page splash.
Yeah.
Oh, but you're not in the splash.
Well, I'm on one half. I'm on mostly on one, and then I have one frame on the other side. So I am. I'm across the splash.
Oh, okay. Oh, if you're in the splash, actually, like, yeah.
Oh, it's not good. It's not the big splash. It's not the, you're right, it's not the...
The main splash.
The main splash.
Yeah,
right.
Which introduces...
It's the splash that I care about.
Right.
I don't think it's called a splash anymore, but yes.
Right.
Yes.
Yeah. And in that same issue, I also have positive things about the Time Warner Comcast merger.
Yeah. That's great. That's really great. So anyway, if you want to get a free copy, if you're a cheapskate, play What the Heck Is It game and use your brain to get a copy of the magazine. Head on over to gizwiz.biz. You can scroll down. There is a little link on the side, and you will have to guess, what the heck is this? This is the full gadget. It's not part of it. At the beginning, when we started this, we didn't even know what it was. Diggity had it lying around, but we have since figured it out. It's quite obvious to me that this is a way to store cushions, pillow cushions, so that they don't get dust on them. So you put the cushion down here, this little thing over on the top, make sure that if you're storing them for a long time, they don't get dusty. When you have friends over and you want to throw your pillow cushions out, it's quite easy to just pull them right off this rack and put them out for all the people to use. Yeah, obviously. So,
yes, okay, good.
Obviously.
Just remember, 25 words or less.
Oh, 25 words or less.
That.
Okay, that's a good good thing to mention. Send that over. There are 12 Mad Magazines for the correct answer and 24 for unique, funny, creative, and interesting answers. And as you can see from my description, the bar is set pretty low for the creative answers. And yeah, so go ahead and do that. Make sure that you subscribe to the show at twit.tv/ Giz Wiz, and you can watch us live at live.twit.tv every Thursday at around 4:30 Pacific is when we get on the stream and start setting up, and we'll start sometime after that. We also have a t-shirt going on right now.
Ooh.
If you head on over to teespring.com/twit, we only have 12 days left to get the Twit Brick House t-shirt. This is in commemoration of us moving into the Brick House, so we have the established date on the back of the shirt. It's been 3 years now. Our anniversary was just not too long ago. This is not only in white and black, but also in a guy cut and in a lady cut as well. So in both colors, which is kind of nice. So head on over to teespring.com/twit for that. Anything else we got to plug?
Boy, no, I think we're golden. I think we've done it.
Giz Wiz Doubt. I'll see ya next week.
And I'll be here.